Well, I went to the thrift store today, and for the first time in almost a month, I actually bought something. It was this IBM ThinkPad. It says $9.99, but today was the 25% off day, so I paid about $7.49 plus tax for it. Some kind of sticker on there. And it's a ThinkPad T20. And it can't be that old because it has a DVD-ROM drive on the side there. On the back, we have a Kensington lock slot, an S video output jack, but it needs a special connector, serial, parallel, VGA, modem, Ethernet, AC adapter, USB, probably just USB 1.1. and a PS2 mouse port. And on this side we have a cooling vent, PC card slots, your typical, I think it's two type 2 or one type 3 with the eject button, an infrared port, and the audio jacks for headphones, line in, or microphone. And on the bottom underneath the keyboard, it looks like two stereo speakers. Then there's the battery. In here is where the memory would go. There's two slots, they're both vacant, so I hope it has some built into the motherboard. And this is the slot for the modem and Ethernet card. And a connector for a docking base or port replicator. Came originally with Windows 98 second edition. Type 2647, made in Mexico. It says 2000 on there. ThinkPad T20. Written as two words, ThinkPad. There's the battery taken out. It's 10.8 volt, 4 amp hour lithium ion. Probably totally dead. And then there's the little backup battery for the CMOS. And when we open up, we get the traditional ThinkPad track point with a third mouse button. I don't know if that does the scrolling like my X60 does, but I guess I'll find out. And the very nice tactile ThinkPad keyboard, far superior to pretty much any other laptop keyboard of the past decade at least. And some extra hotkeys here for volume up and down and mute, just like my X60, and even the ThinkPad button, which I think gets you into the CMOS setup when you're turning it on. Power button, indicator lights, and more indicator lights there, which are designed to be visible when the lid is closed. A little built-in microphone there, and the old multicolor IBM ThinkPad logo. There's a little bit of wear on the spacebar, but otherwise the keys don't look all that worn out. The lettering is all intact and it's not all shiny like a heavily used keyboard would be. And it has the stickers for Pentium 3 and designed for Windows 2000 or Windows 98. And the LCD is a nice big 14-inch size. So it didn't come with a power supply, but I happen to have one of these lying around from one of my older ThinkPads, so let's try it out. So let's plug it in and see what happens.
Ah! Jesus!
Okay, the battery indicator turned orange. Now let's try turning it on. We got a beep code. I probably should write that down to see if I can look it up. The battery indicator was flashing, but is no longer. I'm guessing that beep code is no memory because it has two slots in there and they're both empty. Well, a quick Google search and I found a hardware maintenance manual for this ThinkPad from Lenovo's website, and it lists the beep code, so I'll turn it on and listen to the beeps. That was this code here, which refers to the memory or the system board. So my guess was right. Well, I had to steal it out of my compact Evo N400C And I forgot how small and light this laptop is. It's really amazing for its age. It's also a Pentium 3 designed for Windows 2000, and in this case, Windows NT 4 instead of 98. But anyway, this is also a Pentium 3 laptop, and it's really, really thin and light. I forgot how small it actually is. Look at that. And that's including the battery in there, too. Anyway, that is now down to 128 because I took the other 128 out of it. And the question is, which one of these slots is the first one to use? I guess I'll have to just try both and see what works. I looked it up and this laptop does call for PC100 SD RAM, so it should work, assuming I have the right slot. Okay, let's see what happens this time. Gonna work. Screen lit up. Aha! Okay, F1 for BIOS setup. Well, it took a while, but it did enter the BIOS setup and I adjusted the values to my liking, so now we can save and exit and see what happens. Screen looks like it's in good shape. Might be a stuck pixel there. There's one green dot there, but that's nothing to complain about. Okay, check date and time settings. Oh, okay, I forgot the option, date and time. Well, let me change that. All right, got that set, and there's also this information here. It is a Pentium 3 700. It is detecting the 128 megs of RAM I installed. BIOS is from 1999. So let's restart. Here you can see that stuck pixel right between the A and the D in the ThinkPad. Not too sure about this hard drive. It seems to sit there for a long time doing nothing. Up. Oh. Semantic go back. Well, I guess the hard drive is working. Aha! Windows XP Home Edition, so somebody did upgrade it from the original Windows 98 came with. In which case is going to be quite slow with only 128 megs to run Windows XP. But at this point, if it shows promise, it's definitely worth spending a couple bucks to max out the RAM. I think it can go up to 512 megs with one 256 meg in each of those two slots. Alright, Megan or Tim? Well, I'll choose Megan since it's the first one there. Hard drive is rather noisy. Uh-oh, do you want to activate Windows? Well, I can always reinstall it, so that's no big deal. Still grinding away there. Okay, that is working. And then there's the mute button. Alright. Look how long it took just to bring up this window. Just for fun, I plugged in the Ethernet cable so I can try activating Windows over the internet and see if it lets me. I don't have any product keys for a Home Edition. No, I don't want to register. Unable to establish a connection. Well, remind me later, see if that lets me into Windows at least. Well, logging off. Well, I managed to at least boot it up into safe mode so I can see what it has. Hard drive is an IBM. Graphics is S3. Savage IX. Is it Matsushita DVD-ROM drive? That's a floppy controller, even though there's no floppy in it. PCI Busmaster IDE controller. Infrared. 56K 3COM modem V90. Ooh, whole lot of networking stuff here. Wireless G notebook adapter. I don't know if that's built in or if that's a card somebody had and then took out. There's the 3COM 10100 Ethernet. Some kind of unknown device. Card bus slots. Serial and parallel. Pentium 3. Crystal Sound Fusion audio. There's the Intel USB controller, and I looked up that model number, and it is only USB 1.1, unfortunately. Let's try to see how big that hard drive is. I don't think it stopped grinding the whole time I've been using it. Okay, looks like 12 gigs, which is rather small, but for the age of this computer, it was pretty typical. In addition to removing the memory, looks like the previous owner also deleted all their personal documents because I couldn't find anything of interest. Looks like it was last used in May 2008. And yeah, nothing much on here. Just some of the applications that they left behind. Yeah, they must have put in a PC card wireless G adapter, which I have one of those. Norton System Works, an old antivirus software. They do have Office 2003 on here, which would be nice if I could keep, but I don't have the product key for this home edition of Windows. So, basically is working, and it's probably worth putting some extra memory in at least, and reinstalling Windows XP Professional. Don't have much use for it, but for the price I paid, I definitely can't complain, even just having as a spare laptop. Not bad at all.